Yo, what up, you guys? HSTS here, and I know I haven't been doing a review in a super long time, so pardon me if I make any mistakes or anything. So anyways, I am reviewing the Gears of War, Clayton Carmine, and Marcus Fenix, the, I don't know, 3-4 inch scale. There is, I think, the 7-inch ones, 6-7-inch ones, which I will review later on. I'm just reviewing these guys just because they're new and the new Gears of War Judgment just came out like a few days ago. It came out on the 19th. So anyways, let's get started in the review. So I'll review Marcus first before I get into the figure or anything. Here is the bigger version of Marcus, his counterpart, as you can see them side to side here. And they do look the same, but I'll show you there's more stuff that this guy has that this guy doesn't. So first, for his accessories, he comes with one Retrolancer, which is nice detail. I do like the paint applications and everything. It has a peg right there, so you could peg it in. His peg hole there, but you do want to be careful, so when you peg it in, you don't want to rip it off quickly because the peg here will come off and it'll stay there, which really sucks. It happened to me before on the Halo figures. And then the handle fits nicely in the hand, but you do want to be careful with the handle because it is pretty soft. You don't want it to come off. So now let's get into the detail. So here is his head sculpt. Sorry, you can't really see it all clearly, but here is his head sculpt. It is okay. I do like how they did the scar. There is some shading, and the eyes are just kind of weird. It has that weird stare. And on the other Marcuses I saw, like, the eyes are like glowing. I don't know why. I think this one has the best eyes. Here's a comparison of their head sculpts, as you can see. And I noticed, like, he doesn't have that beard thing as he has, that beard right there. He doesn't have the beard. Interesting. And then for the body armor, it has nice detail and everything. I do like it, but there's no blue here. You know how it kind of lights up? You can kind of see the blue there. Like, the armor lights up, the blue there, kind of. They didn't paint it on this figure, which kind of sucks. But the paint applications, the paint applications on the body armor is still nice. And I noticed the sleeves here are brown towards this figure. They're brown, but like it's white right there, which is kind of weird. He has that, I don't know, the strap thing. And here is his tattoo. You can't really see it because of the lighting. Kind of see it, but yeah. His gloves, nicely done. And then his belt, it has nice paint applications, but they didn't put the skull right there on the belt, which sucks. Pants nice, I like the shading. And the boots, they just painted a solid gray and a little black wash. Towards this one, it has like some brown shades to it, where this one's just all gray with a little black wash. So I guess the figure is okay in detail and sculpt, but I do like it how they did put like black wash and some shading, so it does look still pretty good. For his articulation, his head goes up just that much, but it does go down pretty well. It goes side to side, and it could go 360. Just be a little careful with the joints. He doesn't have that in and out joint thingy, like right here, how this figure has it. He doesn't, sadly, but it does go in and out at the shoulders. It could go 360, but this part kind of hinders it. Bends one point at the elbow, 360 at the wrist, and it does go up and down. And there is no bicep swivel, which kind of sucks. He has this waist joint that kind of could go up and down and does work. It could go 360, but just be careful or else the joint will snap off. The legs go up, down, in, and out. It has a little upper thigh swivel, bends one point at the knee, rotates at the knee as well, and there's no ankle articulation, which sucks. So I guess the articulation is just okay. So now I'm going to review Carmine, Clayton Carmine, which is my favorite character in Gears of War 3. So anyways, first starting off with his accessory, which is the Lancer, which is pretty nice. I like how they did the chainsaw. They put some blood on it, which is really cool. Paint apps are awesome. And he does have that peg hole like Marcus. So anyways, let's get into the detail on this video. So for his head sculpt, it is pretty good. It is video game accurate. I do like how they did the blue and the eyes on the helmet. Very nice. And the body armor, I do like how they put a black wash, which just looks really awesome. And his tattoos are awesome. They're better than Marcus's. I noticed that the paint job on Carmine is better than Marcus's, but Marcus's range of movement is better on his articulation. But here, you can't really read it, but I think it's like an angel with a cross that says Anthony Benjamin RIP, which is his two brothers that died. And he has a lancer right there, bullets right there. Looks really cool. Here is his belt, and I don't know if he had a skull on his belt in the video game. I didn't really pay attention to that, but it has a nice wash to it and good sculpting. And I noticed they didn't put on Grub Killer on his body armor, which really sucks because that's an awesome part or an awesome little piece to his body armor, and they didn't add that, which really sucks. But anyways, he has nice bullets there. Pants are nice, and I don't have the seven inch Carmine, so I can't really compare it. Boots are nice. So yeah, that is his sculpt and detail and everything. And I don't really have to go over the articulation since the articulation is the same as Marcus's. So that is my review of the Gears of War 3. Marcus Fenix and Clayton Carmine. So Gears of War 3 is really awesome. Played the game, loved it. Way better than Gears of War 2, which I did play Gears of War 2, Gears of War 3, have them both. I don't have Gears of War 1. I don't even bother of getting it. Maybe I might get it, but I beat Gears of War 2 and 3. Gears of War 4 Judgment, I don't know about getting it because I heard it's not about Dom and Marcus. It's about Baird, Cole, and these other two people. It's about before Dom and Marcus came and how like Baird got demoted because Baird was part of he was the squad leader of the Kilo squad. So anyways, yeah, Gears of War is awesome. So I do recommend these two figures. There is Baird. I saw him, but I didn't really bother to pick him up just because I like Carmine and Marcus way more. So anyways, thanks for watching, guys, and I hope you enjoyed my video, and please subscribe. Peace out.